I'm seeing things in my head, like little sparks firing off. And it's not until the very last moment that those sparks tell me what on earth they mean.
I've never encountered anyone like this.
He absolutely blew my mind.
To scientists, this man is a gold mine, a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity.
This could be the linchpin that spawns off a new field of research.
Why are they all so excited?
Genius. It's not human.
Daniel Tammet claims that since he was 4 years old, he's been able to do huge calculations in his head. So, in August 2002, we drop by, armed with a calculator.
And you can't see this calculator that I've got here, can you?
We first ask Daniel to multiply 37 by itself, four times.
Okay. 37 to the power of 4. One million.
Yeah.
874,161. Amazing.
Just to make sure that people say, well, perhaps you just know a few of these off by heart, let me just choose another one.
Next, we asked him to divide 13 by 97.
That's
as far as my calculator goes.
Okay.
Brilliant.
185.
Okay.
567.
You're carrying on.
I'm carrying on. Do you want me to stop or?
How many points can you do it to?
100. Nearly 100.
At this point, we borrowed a computer that gave us the answer to 32 decimal places.
Okay, 0.134026185567.
As he went on, every single number was correct. And he even surpassed the computer.
4, 6, 3, 9, 1, 7, 5, 2, 5.
You've reached the end of the computer. It's all 100%. Amazing. When you're pointing to the table and doing shapes with your fingers, what's going on there?
I'm seeing the numbers, but I'm not seeing them. It's strange.
I'm seeing pictures, shapes and patterns. Almost like a square, like the texture of water, drops, ripples almost. Like something reflective. It's something you can look through, almost metallic, like bubbles,
like a half cloud,
a bit like a flash.
It sounds preposterous, but if it's true, it blows away scientific theory. Daniel's brain seems to be doing something almost magical. It appears to be doing maths without him actually having to think. As if this wasn't enough, Daniel is also a wizard with words. He knows 9 languages and says he could learn to speak a new one in just a week. How can Daniel do such enormous calculations in his head? And is it really possible to learn a language in just 7 days? Currently a freelance tutor, Daniel has agreed to be tested by scientists. And we'll also be calling his bluff. Without warning, we'll give him a week to master a totally new language before going live on national television. But our journey begins in Oxford. In March 2004, Daniel took us by surprise with a dazzling memory stunt.
The ambition is to remember pi to 22,500 decimal places and to recite it in a live environment with invigilators who will be checking and making sure, obviously, that the recitation is correct from start to finish.
Pi is the circumference of a circle, divided by its diameter. It's a number with no pattern, but seems to be infinite. Daniel reckoned he could reel off the first 22,500 decimal places without a mistake.
1 4 1 5 9 2 6 5 3 5 8 2 0 9 7 4 9 4 4 2 3 6 4 8 0 8 8 1 0 9 2 5 9 0 3 4 6 9 0 8 5 7 7 8 0 6 9 9 5 5 7 1
2 hours later, and Daniel is barely halfway.
Absolutely staggering. It's sort of beautiful to listen to the flow of numbers. It's beautiful to see the concentration. It's always amazing to be in front of one of the world's extraordinary persons.
Religious. Quite recitation of numbers. It's mesmerizing.
5 6 7 0 9 1 1 0 5 1 7 2 1 0 2 8 7 4 8 1 9 9 6.
After 5 hours and 9 minutes, Daniel is nearing the finish line. His recall has been flawless.
3 5 8 7.
Finished.
Yeah.
It's gobsmackingly brilliant.
Brilliant, yes. But does this mean that Daniel could also have learned by heart thousands of different calculations? Or does he, as he claims, have some strange power to see the answers in his head? His childhood holds a dramatic clue. One of 9 children brought up in East London, Daniel claims that he's been able to do massive calculations since he was only 4.
I had quite a severe seizure as a very small child. A series of seizures and a diagnosis of epilepsy was made.
His childhood fits seem to have changed something in his brain.
It's really from that time that I started to see pictures in my mind, images started to form.
Intuitively, Daniel also began to perceive the patterns within numbers. Cases like this are extremely rare, yet there are others who have also suffered injury to the brain, only to emerge with a startling and often similar kind of talent. Orlando Serrell was just 10 when he received his fatal blow.
Me and a couple of friends were playing baseball. I was a batter. When I ran to first base, the guy threw the ball, and the ball hit me on my left side of the head. It was a hard hit, right up in this area, right up in there. And I just laid on the ground. I didn't go to hospital, didn't get no treatment or nothing.
To his surprise, Orlando soon discovered that he could name the day of the week and recall the weather for any date since his accident.
February 17th, 1980 was on a Sunday, it was sunshine and clear skies. June 3rd, 1985 was on a Monday, it was hot. March 28th, 1990 was on a Wednesday, sunshine and clear skies. Sunday was hot. June 2nd, 1985 was on a Wednesday. December 23rd, 1992 was on a Wednesday. December 24th, 89 was on a Sunday, cloudy. I can't explain it, but it pops right into my head.
Somehow, the circuitry in his brain is computing calendar dates.
What part of my brain is doing this, I don't know.
Both Orlando and Daniel seem to possess special powers of perception, as well as enhanced memory. There are only a handful of people like this worldwide, and they are known to science as savants.